Well, Uncle Stoner name originated over in Amsterdam. Just like the plant and how it makes life simpler and easier for people, that's what I try and do, is make life simpler and easier for people. And after being over to Amsterdam and traveling through other countries, I seen how it's hard for some tourists to get to know places and stuff. So I started a little tour, free tour from a flying pig hostel called the Flying Pig Hostel in Amsterdam. And I used to take people out and show them around and stuff. I took about 25, 30 kids out, and we get back to this room. You're like our favorite uncle that takes care of us, wants us to learn the true knowledge, but also make sure you're safe when you're doing it. And so that caught on, and I started wearing shirts that said Uncle Stoner. And then as also going to Amsterdam, the main reason I went there is for genetics. And so when I started growing in Amsterdam, some of my genetics flower got over to Amsterdam from Cali, and they saw how the passion and love of my way I grew, it reflects back in the plant. And that's one thing about the plant. If you give it that true love and earnest and showing that, you know, it'll give you what you want and what you need.
You are also an activist for medical marijuana, in particular for PTSD, is correct?
I got into the army. And there was a few things that happened in the army and stuff, so due to the incidences and stuff and things and conditions I suffered through the military, I have a form of PTSD. Anxiety, paranoia. I discovered after the VA misdiagnosing me, saying I'm bipolar, I'm this, shoving all these other bad medications down me, you know, Trazodone, lithium, Haldol, that gave me like a zombie. I'm like, I didn't want to do anything, or I wanted to go out and search out and do other drugs and give me a worse drugs, cocaine, crack, just to try and give me a feeling of life. Finally, when I moved back to Grass Valley, my hometown, I said, you know, I remembered how when I smoked it as a kid, how it made me feel. And I'm like, and I saw, I started growing and smoking it. And I'm like, wow, I noticed it started giving me a better equality of life back. I wasn't having as much nightmares. I wasn't remembering as much of them nightmares. I wasn't as edgy. When I'm around big crowds like this, normally if I'm not medicated, I'm real edgy, I'm nervous. Sometimes paranoia kicks in because of my PTSD. But with the cannabis and this natural plant, I noticed that it makes things tranquil. I'm able to focus correctly. My thoughts slow down. I'm not edgy. And I see that it works for me. And I know that it works for other veterans that have the same problems that I do and other elements. And so I believe that I just wanted to get out there and share that message with not just veterans, but the whole world.
I am Mila from the Pollinator Company, and they started calling me the Queen of Hash in America. It is not something that I devised, but they do it because I think I invented the first mechanical method for separating the THC crystals from all the plant matter. Up until that time, for thousands of years, if people made hashish, it was either rubbed or shook, but it was all manual. And so the Pollinator was the first machine that could do the job.
And you are a cannabis activist by many, many years. How do you see the situation all around the world that now is changing in cannabis?
The situation for cannabis is really changing all around the world. You have extremes from like Uruguay, where it's legal, and then in Holland, where we had so much freedom, now it is going completely backwards. They're closing coffee shops, they want to close grow shops. In the south of Holland, no foreigner can buy anything anymore in a coffee shop. So it's really strange to see how it moves up and down. Like America was the inventor of the war on drugs. And where was it legal? In Washington State, right in the heart of America. And I think this is really great.
There is something that I don't ask you that you want to say.
Just I love you all.
Thank you very much.